looking, the talented, the rock star, Mehran Aminian. Durud bar shoma, Mehran Aziz.
Salam, salam mubarak, Iman jun.
Eid shoma mubarak, ba un rish khoshgeletun.
مرسی از
قربونت. خیلی خوشحالم که این اولین آشنایی که داریم از طریق ویدیو or even unfortunately haven't met in person. ولی میدونی یه موقعی وقتی با یه نفر آدم کانکت میکنه با همون دو سه تا تکست مسیج اول میدونی که آدم میتونه باهاش حال بکنه، میدونی که باحال. And so you're one of those people که از همون اول خوشحال شدم و هم از طریق مرجان هم از طریق مونا when I was asking hey I need some awesome people to come part of it, you know, your name kept on popping up and stuff, and so I'm glad که on short notice we got connected. So خیلی خوش آمده به برنامه Celebration of Norouz.
I'm happy to be here.
خیلی ممنون. So you're in Toronto right now. How did you spend your Norouz?
Should I, if I want to be honest, I just slept through it. من میخواستم که بیدار بشم ولی فکر کردم که برای اینکه یکم فرش باشم و اینا ترجیح دادم که امسالو. حالا جا جالب بگم، من مادر بزرگم همیشه خیلی تاکید داشت. It's okay if I carry on in Farsi, right?
هرجوری که دلت میخواد. Yes, absolutely.
آره. نه اینو یه قصه رو بعد به فارسی بگم. مادر بزرگ من همیشه فکر میکرد که هر کاری که در اون لحظه بکنی تمام سال هم کار میکنی و همیشه من یادم مثلا هرس میخورد اگه کسی مثلا دستجویی بود میگه هیچی دیگه، مادر بزرگ من دیوونه میشد، بیا بیرون. حالا من احتمالا امسال قرار بیشتر بخوابم، امیدوارم که
oh wow great. So at least you're going to be well rested by the end of the year, you know.
Hope so yeah.
Hope so what have you done in the past year during this crazy pandemic 1399 to keep yourself busy? Because, you know, like there, I think there's two ways to have handled this. One is, you know, you kind of just do absolutely nothing and you kind of go down the path of tambali, or you use this as an opportunity to even get more creative, more, you know, as an artist that you are. You know, I based on the video that I saw, the one that's oh my goodness, the name just kind of dropped my Hanooz. Like I could tell that you decided to go the artistic route, making a super cool, super creative, different type of video. So tell us about the last year from an artistic standpoint.
Yeah, I guess it's been a roller coaster for pretty much everybody. You know, we started when COVID hit us. Not to mention that these are the couple of disasters that we had as Iranian before that. I'm still speechless about it. So we did have that, and then we had the protests in Iran, and it followed with the COVID. So we actually Iranians hit pretty hard during 1399. Like everybody else, I had a roller coaster of feelings and emotions, and you know, I at some point I was completely, you know, I dare to say even depressed to some extent. And like everybody else, I packed up a few pounds sitting at home, just eating, not doing nothing else, binge watching TV. And then I said, okay, enough is enough. That's a new reality. Let's just make something meaningful out of it. So I started, as you mentioned, I started creating more pieces of music. Hanooz, actually, if you pay attention to the lyrics, is actually you know, to self, if you will, that okay, there is still a tomorrow. So just get your crap together. Let's move. Let's be positive. We will see through this one as well. That's how I felt by peace, basically. Found my peace.
I mean, I definitely did pay attention to the lyrics, and I really encourage everybody to watch the video. All you got to do is go on YouTube and. You know, it's there under Mehran featuring Lisbeth, L-I-S-B-E-T-H, and it's called Hanooz, and it's got the English subtitles. And the message is very pandemic-centric, where basically, as long as you got your pulse, you have a chance. You have a chance to fight, and you know, you're awake, and you can make it. And like, I just thought that lyrically it was great, and visually it was awesome. I thought you did an amazing job, and I thought it's very... now, if you know, and so and it just came out like a week ago, I noticed, right, or something like that. So it's fresh out the oven, you know, and I hope that it circulates very nicely for you. So Mehran, for those that don't know, well actually I don't know either, so for us who don't know, can I ask, when was the last time that you spent Norouz in Iran?
Oh gosh, it was Norouz, it was 15 years or 14 years ago.
15 years ago. یه خاطره قشنگی دارین که از نوروز که دوست دارین که شیر بکنین؟
من از طرف پدر به شیراز برمیگرده پدر من و نوروز برای من هنوز یه جورایی معنیش شیراز و اون حال و هوای عیدیه که تو فرض کن که مثلا وقتی که میری سال نو یک دو فروردینه و تو میری مثلا توی مقبره حافظ هستی، اونجا هستی، اون حال و هوا رو میبینی، باورت میشه بیشتر you feel belong to this culture, you know. و این یکی از چیزایی که من بیشتر از همه شاید میسش میکنم و کم دارم این رو اینجا. خب به هر حال تو تورنتو هم هستیم، آب و هوای تورنتو رو که میشناسین، یه مقدار اینجا اون وایب چون نیستش. من هنوز بهترین روزایی که با بهترین نوروزایی که یادم میاد نوروزای شیراز هست که با عمو و مادر بزرگ و یه سفره بزرگی بود و خیلی هنوز اون روزا برای من هنوز فرشه و تو ذهنم همیشه هست.
That's beautiful. از فان انوشم که اینجا هستش.
من شیراز خیلی بودم.
ایشون شیراز شیراز بود. So while you're talking, he's like nodding his head and and reflecting on those days. You know what's crazy is the fact that like the reason why I asked this question from everybody is like I've never lived in Iran and so I've never experienced Nowruz in Iran. I went one time for 2 weeks like 20 years ago, but I did go to Shiraz. My dad took me to Shiraz, Isfahan, Tehran in a whirlwind 13-day trip. And so Taht Jamshid Aftin, and you know my dad did a great job of being able to do as much as we could in a 2 week period. And you know it sucks. A whole generation of Iranians are growing up and we have to hear these stories from other people. And so on one hand, it sucks. But on the other hand, it's the reason why we're doing this and why I'm so appreciative that you're a part of this live stream, because I want to make sure that I feel being Iranian and I feel our culture and stuff, you know? And so I want to thank you for being one of the many people that even during a pandemic continues to produce music that is a reflection of our history and traditions and culture. And, you know, it's you guys play such an integral role in people like me to still be connected, because music is one way that you can kind of stay connected, obviously, with our culture and stuff. So I hope that you realize that even though you're doing it all for yourself, meaning like as an artist, do it, and then you hope that other people enjoy it. And I just want you to know that there are many people like me that enjoy it, that appreciate it, that I know you had a hard year the past year, but I hope that all of that is now behind and that you can continue to flourish as an artist and spread your creativity to the rest of the world so that we feel connected to our history and culture, man. So really appreciate that.
I'm hoping very much. So
tell me about what kind of upcoming projects, because I know you have your hand in multiple things with multiple people and multiple aspects, like a true artist. What can we expect from Mehran Aminian in the coming months? And for those people who are not familiar with your work, how do you describe the type of work that you do and how they can follow you and support your craft?
Sure. A little bit of background about my music. I as you mentioned, my style is rock music, and it's to be more basically, to be exact, it's progressive rock. Progressive rock has a very special place in Iranian hearts. I know for a fact that many of us, especially my generation, we were brought up and we grew up with listening to bands like Pink Floyd, like Camel, like Dream Theater, that kind of music. And I'm really inspired by big bands like the ones that I just mentioned. So my music is rock, and I try to bring in like elements from Persian music. Sometimes it could be only an instrument, or sometimes it could be a compass, or you know, we call it dastgah in Farsi. I try to mix things up and do some trial and error and try to find something that sound nicely and it makes more sense for Iranian audience as well. Asking about my upcoming projects, I do have a few single tracks that I'm working on. I'm hoping to publish them within 1400. I'm very excited. I'm doing some collabs as well. I know that I think you already had my lovely friend, Babak Amini, on the show.
Yes. Well, yeah, he had a beautiful Nowruz message that we did share earlier. Yes, absolutely.
Fantastic. I'm very excited that we will have a collaboration this year. I'm hoping to finish the recording the song, and hopefully we will have it as a music video sometime during summer this year.
Let me ask you, Mehran, so you mentioned, you know, progressive rock in general, it's a Hanooz to a job. Well, it really, okay, to Jame Iruni, I feel like it's still not, you know, the mainstream type of category. What do you see as far as, like, have you seen like new, more artists that are doing more rock? Like, do you see that it's progressing and growing and getting a bigger following? Like, where do you see like the direction that Persian rock is going?
So here's the thing. I believe there are two ways to approach music. You gotta, as an artist, you gotta know if you wanna be a star, if you will, or you want to be a mainstream artist, or you want to do something niche and target a smaller audience, but still have something like, yeah, some substance. Basically, I made peace with it years and years ago that I want to have probably a couple of thousand. Now, fortunately, I have tens of thousands. I'm happy about it. I'm completely comfortable with that, to have a smaller audience, but try to leave something behind that people actually can, some people can connect with. At least we can broaden basically we can create the taste for Persian audience. So to answer your question, we do not have a growing audience, but we still have people who can connect to this type of music. And I think it makes sense to let mainstream artists do their job. They're fantastic at it. I'm happy. But let us have a smaller group of audience and try to come up with sounds that people don't get somewhere else. And at least we have something to basically introduce to Persian community. Listen to this one as well. I know you spend your time mostly listening to mainstream music, but this is something that you could probably learn something or find interesting as well.
So first of all, great response. What I would like to know is, unfortunately, given the state of the Persian entertainment industry as a whole, especially after the pandemic, you know, even the mainstream artists, many of them are really just struggling, you know, to kind of just make ends meet. And now you're like in a niche market. How can the Persian community, you know, support, the people like you with it that are already like in a niche? You know, how can we make sure that artists like you are given oxygen to be able to, you know, focus on the art instead of worrying about any financial challenges or pressures, you know, like, so when you are dealing with a smaller audience, although I understand and appreciate the niche aspect of it, at the end of the day, you know, for a true artist to be able to perform at his optimal level, the financial component needs to be something that is a kind of addressed. And so how can we as a global Persian community, as I'm trying to basically, you know, huddle us up together, like me being one of many, many people, that's the best, you know, what can we do to support you? What can we do to support people like you that are, you know, doing this category of music that is a niche?
That's a very great question, actually. I think the main thing that I could use help on is to spread the pieces, like the music, mm-hmm. you know, because I'm fortunate enough to have to be able to secure, for example, sponsors for my video, because mm-hmm. there is no way you can actually make enough money to you know, if I break even on my production, I'm always happy. Mind you that I have a 9-to-5 to basically sponsor my own videos in the first place, but then I can try to make it make sense financially with having sponsors. The main challenge here, though, is to make sure that the reach of the music to the society. The best thing I could ask is to please, if you like something, do share with your friends. Let them know that, okay, have you heard this new one? The new one from such and such, not only Mehran Aminian, from any indie artist, which is absolutely crucial for us to have to use this help from every single audience to reach a broader audience.
But if I'm I noticed to have in music video to you had, you know, the English subtitles, you know, which was very unique because most of the Persian videos, they don't have that. Are you noticing that there is an appeal from non-Persians or non-Farsi speaking, that's why you're kind of doing it? Or was that just unique to this particular video that you wanted to make sure that the thing is spelled out?
Actually, it happened other way around. Somebody approached me, non-Persian speaking, obviously, and say, "Hey, this is a cool music. I love the music. And I love the video. What does it say?" And so, oh, okay. So we got to do something about it. And I think it makes sense for all of us, especially with music that actually non-Persian speaking audience can relate to. We definitely need to do it more often just to make sure that we can actually connect to non-Persian speaking audience as well.
I love that. I mean, that's definitely a way to diversify your demographic and, you know, capture some other people, because, you know, honestly, there's so many people that really love things about Persian, whether it's music or food or culture. But the problem is that sometimes they don't even know about it. You know, like there's a reason why there's so many Americans or non-Persians and non-Latins that love Latin music, is because they have the power of numbers and it's all over everywhere. So like you're kind of bound to kind of stumble upon it. But like Persian music is still not something that has kind of like reached, obviously, to a global audience. And it takes a lot of work, but it takes all of us to at least spread the word. So they can follow you on Instagram, where?
Please, yeah. Mehran.Aminian. I think it's pretty easy.
Yeah. And then on your YouTube, is it under the same name?
Yeah. YouTube is Google. Sorry, just put search for Mehran Aminian and I have my own channel. Please share and subscribe. I try to come up with more cool tunes. Hopefully people can enjoy.
Beautiful. Well, Mehran, I could talk to you for a long, long time, but I'd like to kind of just end this conversation by having you give a message to your fellow compatriots.
First of all, I want to basically congratulate you guys for doing this, and a big, big compliment for the name that you guys chose. فکر میکنم که ما هممون به عنوان ایرانی ها, we need to unite and concur. That's exactly what we need to do. که معمولاً اپوزیت اون چیزی که انجام میدیم. به همه میخوام یه بار دیگه سال نو رو تبریک بگم. امیدوارم که سال بسیار خوب پر از سلامتی و شادی داشته باشین و اینکه بتونیم در کنار هم از سختی‌های فعلی که توی ایران داریم و بیرون ایران همه دنیا داره رد بشیم, روزای بهتری در راه داشته باشیم. مرسی.
خیلی ممنون. واقعا من میتونم بگم که امیدوار هستم و با همین تهیه کردن این برنامه, I mean, listen, this live stream is not getting millions of views or hundreds of thousands of views, but for me, a seed was planted. Because we're putting together a coalition, we're putting together a badass army of badass people doing amazing things, and it's a power of numbers, you know. And
absolutely.
And you know, I'm so incredibly grateful for having so many talented and yet humble individuals that have you know, joined us in this thing. But I have no doubt that that's we can continue to support each other on our separate endeavors. But then موفقیت شما, موفقیت دوستان دیگه توی برنامه ها, به شما موفقیت هممون, you know. And so that's really the reason why I came up with that company name about a year and a half ago before the pandemic, is because I'm a true believer in uniting and conquering. And you know, we've all learned the hard way what happens when people do not unite and become one voice and one hand. And so I think our generation is learning, and that's why we're seeing so much more strength and so much more unity, and it's a beautiful thing to watch. And I appreciate you uniting with us and being a part of this, and آرزو موفقیت. I can say that I wasn't fully aware or following a lot of your work in the past years, and I'm glad that now I have even more reasons to want to support you, because you're a class act, and we're vibing together, and I cannot wait to see all the great music and art that you're going to create for the world, my friend. So امیدوارم که سال خوبی داشته باشی, امیدوارم که زود ببینیم همدیگه از نزدیک, و تو همه کار موفق باشی.
دمت گرم, مرسی مانشو,
خداحافظ, به امید دیدار.